بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد عليه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم. Then from Allah's names is Al-Ghani, and Al-Ghani means the one who is rich. When we think of richness in this dunya, automatically we think of wealth. But when we talk about Al-Ghani, Allah's name, the rich, we are talking about the one who is free of all need. And this name has come in the Quran in 18 different places. An example of this is where Allah says, وَرَبُّكَ الْغَنِيُّ ذُو الرَّحْمَةِ. And your Lord is Al-Ghani, the one who is free of all need, the possessor of mercy. Another example of this is where Allah says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ أَنْتُمُ الْفُقَرَاءُ إِلَى اللَّهِ اللَّهُ هُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ. O mankind, surely it is you who are in need of Allah. As for Allah, He is free of all need and worthy of all praise. So as we mentioned, this name comes in the Quran in 18 different places, showing its great importance. I'd like to give you three examples of the richness of Allah. The first one is that He is free from the obedience of the slaves. What does that mean? It means that the obedience that which we put forth as the slaves of Allah, it does not benefit Allah. He's not relying upon that, nor does it increase His dominion. But rather, He is completely free and perfect. He's not in need of the good that we do. So there's no need for us to feel like we are doing Allah any favors by worshipping Him. But rather, that benefit comes to us directly, in this world and in the next. The second example I bring to your attention is that Allah is completely free from all types of deficiency. Allah says in the Quran, قَالُوا اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ وَلَدًا سُبْحَانَهُ وَالْغَنِيُّ لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. And they claim that Allah has begotten a son. Glory be to Him. And to Him belongs, rather He is Al-Ghani. He is free of any need. And to Him belongs everything that is in the heavens and in the earth. So from this we understand that Allah is completely free from any defects in all of its different forms. The third example I bring to your attention is that Allah is free of not responding to our call, meaning that Allah has promised us when we call upon Him and when we do righteous deeds, He is going to accept our deeds and respond to our call. As He says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي أَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبُ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. Allah says, and when they ask you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about me, then surely I am close. I will respond to the caller when he calls upon me. So these are the three examples that I'd like to bring to your attention about Allah's name, Al-Ghani. And surely Allah knows best.